with Inge. So, when I was 40 years old, I was working at a dream job. I was working for an international organization and I was directing learning innovation, and we did really well. We worked on continued professional developments in low-resource areas using mobile learning. We developed the Moodle for iPhone application, so we really made a difference. We even won a global award in 2006 for that mobile learning in low-resource settings. I felt really good about it, and we had a full team, and I had a lot of responsibilities. But there was one downside. All of my colleagues earned much more money than me. And why was that? Because in that organization, it paid you based on the academic qualifications that you had. And at that time, 40 years old, the only degree I had was secondary school, high school. So at a certain point, I was thinking, look, I want to earn a little bit more money as well. That is nice to have. But I'm a Belgian citizen. And research has shown that Belgium is quite a corrupt country. It is. It's not like Africa, nothing really big, but it's nationwide tax evasion. It's a national sport. It really is. You can ask any Belgian. We do this. So obviously, when I was considering getting a degree, I was thinking maybe I can buy it. You know, it would save me time, it would save me effort. And I'm doing my job anyway, at the master level, so what would be the difference? I truly contemplated that. In the end, I didn't have the guts, I admit. So I earned my degree while working full-time also. Now, at this point in time, I'm working for EIT InnoEnergy, which is European organization, and it provides courses for people working in the sustainable energy sector. I work on a skills engine, and that is where blockchain and education comes in. So let me briefly share the skills engine idea, and then return to the advantages and disadvantages of blockchain. The skills engine uses AI, specifically natural language processing, to distill key concepts from text documents. And we use it to predict where industry is going. We also use it to analyze CVs and resumes of people and see which skills they have and match it to the industry needs. And then we use it to screen all the courses on the internet, all the courses that are described, and also open educational resources. And we cluster those courses together and provide them to the learners so they can address their skills gap. So you can see that the blockchain comes in at the last step. So obviously we were considering what to do with blockchain. Is it really useful? Now, I'm not sure about that. So let me start with the bright side of blockchain. As I mentioned, we cluster courses together and we put them in a personalized learning track and then we offer it to our learner. This means that small bits and pieces come from all around the globe. You have university pieces, you have TED Talks, you have corporate academic courses, or short modules of those courses, and we all bring it together. And so in some way, we need to provide a certificate for our employees that will enable us to really link together all those different institutes. So blockchain, yes, nice, a wonderful thing, a real benefit. Blockchain in education offers the opportunity to combine both informal learning and formal learning. experts in our fields that most of the time, as an expert, we learn informally. So if we say, look, blockchain in education is going to be meaningful, surely informal learning needs to be important. Can we know? Another advantage is a combination of hard skills and soft skills. Now, if you go through university, you have this, you learn specific skills and specific, you get information, you create knowledge. But it's, one of the reoccurring criticisms from industry is, yeah, but those who come from university lack specific professional skills. With this, with blockchain, we can look at all of the skills that you have. Nice. This is actually a combination. It's called the human tower, which is on top of the human tower. It's a little kid of 7 years old. So you need to be pretty confident to make this combination of hard skills and soft skills, because deep down there, you see the mathematics of supporting that kid. And then the last one, obviously, each of these X-Men isn't going to say, look, I have a master degree in this or a PhD in that. No, it's about the other skills that they have. Blockchain can go beyond university degrees. Now, the dark side. It consumes massive amounts of energy. And especially, if you remember what Jen said, all of the things on top of blockchain as well, it consumes, in 1 year, in 2018, it consumed as much energy as Ireland did in a year. How can you support it as a sustainable energy company? Then how safe is it? The start of a blockchain, if that isn't completely correct, all that follows will be fraud as well. Meet Inge de Waard. Who knows who this is? Yes. And then you also, as Jan mentioned, so brief, there's not yet an open standard. So we try to figure out how it can make it into a lifelong learning technology. But my main criticism is this: the proof of the pudding is in the eating. Just imagine that I would have bought my degree. I mean, what's the difference? Surely our professional institutes are bright enough to see if they attract a new employee, whether they are skilled for the job or not. I can't imagine that if someone buys a medical degree and says, yes, I'm here. Within the next week, you will have figured it out and know this person is not a medical doctor. Surely. Additionally, if you think about it, what are these degrees worth? You know the essay mills? Anybody? So an essay mill is where a student buys a master degree thesis or buys an assignment, and it's $150 or euros, $200, and you get it done. And on the basis of that, you get a degree. So how truthful are these degrees and how truthful will these certificates be? You can, well, obviously Belgian, you can cheat. Then I also want to give you some very, very, very useful links. But you must go to my slideshare deck. In point of view, download them and have a closer look. It's really useful documents. So my main point is, I don't think learning needs that much security. I think we're overshooting our goal of providing certification, because certification, at the end, is validating the skills that you have in the workplace. And if you don't show them, if you can't show them, it doesn't mean anything, no matter how many certificates you add to this blockchain. So I still wonder, is it worth was just one of those myths to attract new currencies from our funding agencies based on the fact that it is for technology and for future. I wonder. Thank you. Looking forward to